the spinners on his tire. Sub smoke in his 40, windows up. He rolls like it really doesn't give up. Drug lust and two packets in your pocket. You drank all of the tequila. Get loose, street fighter, tear it up. Fresh for work, dripping out of you onto the rug.
It is a welterweight matchup between Nate Diaz and Conor McGregor.
You ready?
So here we go, round one, Nate Diaz versus Conor McGregor. Your thoughts on Conor's approach here in this
game? Conor has to go forward and try to get the left hand off. He knows that he can hit Diaz. He's the faster fighter. Nate needs to move his head, and Nate needs to check leg kicks. Conor did a great job with the leg kicks in fight number two, and I believe that was the key to him getting the victory.
And he lands a big left hand there. Oh, huge right hand. They're certainly getting after it early. It's a big knee!
I mean, he's cutting them down the side. It'd be huge in the leg.
Nice 1-2 there. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the cutter.
He blocks the punch.
Big punch lands through the middle.
By Nate Diaz, not a guy you want to let get going here on the feet, DC.
No, all downhill with this, right? It's the activity that will overwhelm his opponent, and this looks like the start of that. And it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great placement on that uppercut. He's a jerk. He's hurt bad.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard. And, oh, all right, so he catches the kick there and beautifully counters with the takedown. So a nice job turning that defense into some immediate offense there.
He did a great job of turning his defense into his offense, but you can see that he's done that time and time again. He drilled that exact action, and it worked in this instance. You don't know when that leg kick's coming.
Damaging strike there. Oh, right-left combo by McGregor. Nice hook there by Diaz. Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now.
That's a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talk to your coach.
Oh! Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked. Oh, looked like he might have been in range, but misses with the kick. Oh, nice hook by him there. Not necessarily with full power, but certainly found the desired target.
He's throwing those shots to damage your opponent and set up another shot down the middle. He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
The horn sounds for the end of round one. Just like that, here we go with round two. Nate Diaz and Conor McGregor. visibly limping here. Oh! Oh! Another shot. His head's still attached to his body.
The last time I saw an uppercut like that, it was Overeem versus Ngannou. And you know they still haven't found Alistair Overeem's head.
Some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he, who's hurt? Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh, he might be in trouble here after that big diving punch. Back to the feet.
Ooh, what a punch.
Total strikes have found the mark for Conor McGregor. Well, in terms of the accuracy rate, not great. 38% thus far against Nate Diaz. Well, now if you're the opponent, you really got to be careful as Diaz is able to find a home for that right hand yet again.
When Diaz starts landing the right hand, you have got to stay firm. You have got to dig your heels in the ground and say, no way you're going to just run me over. Easier said than done when you're facing Nathan Diaz.
Oh! Huge right hand!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket.
Oh, that's a nice strike.
Whiffs on the straight right hand.
He's throwing every part of himself into a big leg kick.
Big shots being landed on both sides here. Well, DC, headgear's not allowed, but he has raised the hands and he's doing a nice job protecting the dome.
He's doing a great job of blocking his head. A lot of times, those shots to the head will knock you out. Not this time, this guy's making sure nothing lands. Big clutch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, tonight.
The biggest shot that he's landed all night. A massive uppercut land.
Oh, straight right. That shot is blood around. Well, I'm not sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. He's going to survive unless you put him completely.
Third round underway. Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You like this guy.
I like this guy.
Whoa!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this move. Go finish this.
Oh, he might be out. Total strikes have now landed for Conor McGregor. Well, not the greatest land percentage necessarily. 37% the accuracy thus far against Nate Diaz. Well, he continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like he did in the previous round. This is a world-class... Oh, and there it is. Maybe the seminal blow, DC.
This might be the biggest shot of this entire fight. He landed a massive hook to put his opponent on wobbly legs.
Be busy. Whiffs on that offering.
Wow! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Unbelievable. Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
Not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, it creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
Going orthodox now. McGregor's kick is blocked.
good night if that landed.
Well, it's all pace and pressure down the stretch.
Oh. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Well, they won't need to go bonus begging after this one. They're getting a bonus tonight. This fight has been all action from the opening hook.
I mean, what a phenomenal fight. Both fighters should be very proud of themselves.
His misses are entertaining.
Oh! He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Huge block there.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh! Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight. He's hurt.
All right, so the fighters go the distance here tonight, but it went a whole lot better for one of them than the other. Talk us through the replays, champ.
Some decisions are different than others, and his striking really did separate him from the competition. He fought so well in the stand-up game that he should get a very easy decision.
The official decision is in. Bruce Buffer has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard for a decision. All three judges scored this contest 9-28. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, the Notorious Conor McGregor!
All right, nice job by him there as he is your winner via unanimous decision. And sometimes I...